My name is Tirumudi Tulasiraman and I'm here in California Bay Area almost for like 21 years, I guess. One thing that I found after coming here is there is a bunch of talented people here who can do wonderful things which we can't even imagine. And my heart goes out towards the talents. So I started an organization. It's called like Bay Area Fine Arts, which gives a platform where people can come and compete and show their skills on filmmaking. Pavan, thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to take a sneak peek of your film. It is wonderfully done.
Thank you.
I just would like to have a very good interaction with you guys, and I'm very happy that you invited me. Can I just get introduced yourself?
Yeah, sure. I'm Pavan Kumar Raj. I have been doing filmmaking in Bay Area since last 10 years now. I have done various short films in multiple languages, and this is my first film in Hindi. We started this movie like 2 years before, and we are ready to release this movie now. Me and my friend like Srikant, like we both came up with this idea and we wrote this story together. And finally, I'm very excited that we are about to bring this movie in front of you on March 21st. And I would like to introduce my cameraman, director of photography, Natraj.
Yeah, hello. Guys, myself, Natraj. So as Pavan said, we last 2 years it was busy for this project. And I've shot like a couple of indie films also, and it's been released in the Bay Area here. I'm very lucky that I'm in Bay Area, because here there are many aspiring filmmakers like Pavan, and previously we had also shot one movie in Telugu, and this is my first Hindi movie. There were a lot of challenges, but you know, we could cope up and shoot well. So I'm also excited to see the movie.
I would like to introduce my friend, Srikant. We both discuss a lot of films together, and even though Srikant is not like a full-fledged writer, but he helped me a lot in writing some of the scenes in this movie. We discuss a lot about the movie. We are both very passionate about filmmaking.
Hi, myself Srikant. So I got introduced to this project by Pavan. We had like a couple of story discussions which we went, but this story, like, you know, this we thought, like, you know, this would be worth giving it a try. Pavan, like, you know, he, like, whenever he gets something story or a seed inside his head, he'll just try to, you know, get it done. So yeah, this movie, hopefully you all will like this one.
I also want to introduce Bharat. He extensively worked on the sound design.
Right.
I'll let him speak about the project.
Yeah, of course. That's the very important thing on any film. Yeah. So, yeah, please go ahead.
I'm Bharat. This is my third film with Pavan. Pavan always has very unique and interesting stories, so I never miss an opportunity to work with him. And this particular one, I saw the trailer a while ago, and I emailed him saying, like, hey, if you want any help in sound, I'm here. And then when Pavan reached out to me, I was very, very happy to be part of the project.
And I know, like, one of the most wanted person in Bay Area for the filmmakers is Bharat. It is a fortunate thing.
He's a
very highly, you know, these are the talents that elevates the film to the next level, right? So, yeah.
I'm Kiran, and I got an opportunity to work with him to this. So I worked building some miniature kind of thing. So towards art, I worked for this film.
I have a question for you. Yeah. So, okay. Nice.
So I think to introduce Kiran in a better way, I think he's like, being very modest in what he's doing. I feel that Kiran doesn't discover a lot in, he doesn't entitle himself to a particular title or role, but I find him very creative in terms of art and production design.
Right.
And like when we approach him, ask him, okay, this is something we want to build, he does a lot of experimental things.
Wow.
So He builds what you call amazing things out of scrap, actually.
That's great. That's great. That's nice.
Yeah, yeah.
It's all like very unique fields any cine industry needs. So, Pavan, I know, you know, it's very challenging to write a script, imagine yourself what you are thinking, putting into the paper, and like refining it every day, every minute, and then bringing it to the final output on screen, what you imagine, the story. So how did you, which motivates you to carry this from scratch to this big screen?
So, I mean, for myself, this story, actually, I didn't think of making a movie like this. So this is basically based on psychedelic mushrooms. So me and one of my friends were discussing once in a coffee shop. His name is Shravan. Like, he's not in Bay Area now, but like he mentioned his experience after taking these psychedelic mushrooms when he is on high.
Right.
So I was never on any of this pleasurable like marijuana or anything like that. I never tried anything like that. But he just said one thing that really fascinated me, that after he took this mushroom, he showed me some paintings, like some people would do these paintings when they take these mushrooms. And he also told me an experience that he was speaking with a river one whole night.
Oh, wow.
So that imagination of a person himself being alone and speaking with nature itself, it blew my mind, actually. That's where I started this whole story about what if a person is speaking with the river, and essentially that's not the crux of the whole movie. Like, the actual story is something different.
Right.
But sometimes we get some ideas which are very fascinating, and the actual story builds around that one idea. So that flash of idea was the trip feeling that people experience.
Exactly.
So the whole story then expanded in a more sensible way.
I was about to ask you, you know, do you have any, like, what is the, you know, reason for you to pick this genre and develop this thing? Probably if I might have met you, I could have shared one interesting thing. I took my friend who took some drugs to a restaurant. I mean, like, it's a Thai restaurant.
It's legal in California, so
it's legal. So I took him to a Thai restaurant. The moment we went inside, and after like 5 minutes, he said, "Man, I have to leave. Come on, I have to leave. I have to leave. Please take me to my room." And then I was like wondering, you know, what happened? And he said, like, "Hey, everybody is with swords and this thing. They're coming to kill me, man. These guys, they're like kung fu fighters. I'm so scared. Let us take me out." So, anyways, so that's so what's your, this is the inspiration that you got for your story?
I found that it's one of the most challenging thing to bring it onto the screen in terms of sound, in terms of visual. So I think everyone, like, should come together to to put that onto the screen. I honestly believe that we really got that onto the screen, like, in every way, like visually, in terms of music, in terms of sound, in terms of, I mean, you can see all the art forms who are on trip in this
project. Pavan, actually, the people who acted in your film, they actually lived their character. You know, it's a very complicated action thriller. Understanding the story, understanding the character, and then bringing it out like you expect is always a challenge. So how did you manage? Did you give them any drugs? Sorry.
No. As I was saying, right? Like, the actual story was completely different when I put it into the script. This is just the crux of the thing. So I had to explain some other things, like, there are a lot of human emotions in this movie. There's a family, good family story in this movie. So my struggle was not about this, but I had to explain a lot of minute details, like how husband and wife would, the main actor who acted in this movie is Ratnesh Rai. He actually traveled this script for last 2 years.
Right.
And he added a lot of flavor into this movie. Like, he added a lot of sensible things into this film. And we both used to discuss how we can bring a performance. So I had like taken some course, acting course.
Right. Okay.
So to give some tips or some tools to my actors.
Okay.
It's not just like, okay, I want anger. Can you give me some anger? It's not like, I want some laughter here. Can you give me laughter? But I used to give them the situation. And once the scene finishes, what should be the outcome? What should be the state of the characters? Right. So I give them an input, a starting point. And after the scene finishes, how it should end and what should be the state of mind.
Yes.
So to that transition, I think they used to understand, and in like most of the times they took the performance.
They have done an excellent job in this film, everybody, each and everybody. And it's in director's hand to bring the talent out, you know, like what you want. And they actually live their characters. That's what I can say that. And another beautiful thing in your film is, to you, sir, it's awesome. The camera was simply awesome. And where did you find those locations? It's a treat for everybody, you know, the each and every location, the way it's been set, the lighting. And you know, nowadays I see a lot of drone shots because it is easy, but you used in very little at the same time. It's very nice and excellent. So can you share your experience?
Yeah. See, for this project, Pawan was very particular about the look.
Yes.
So before he signed me, before he confirmed me, he gave an assignment saying that he wants this look. Can you give me this look? Then one day myself, I went to beach, shot some shots and everything.
Wow.
Then I showed Pawan. Then he was confident enough to, you know, sign. Then there was a, I remember still the first day of the shoot in the beach.
Yes.
We just went there. So it was a whole one day shoot. In the evening, that's in the sunset.
Okay.
The great challenge was the sun was going down.
Okay.
There are so many things to happen. Actors were there.
Okay.
So we could finish that one. And after the shoot, we have seen the rushes.
Footages.
Then we got confident that this project is going to do something.
Okay.
So that way, I think step by step we improved a lot.
Yeah.
Every time, you know, and I still remember the shoot in the night time.
Okay.
He has taken one whole house as rent.
Right.
Yeah.
And that was a challenging one.
Yeah.
Because we have to shoot till 2 o'clock.
Yeah.
It's a fighting scene.
Yeah.
Right.
It's an action scene. So action scene.
So I would say the real hero of this of any film is the cameraman, because what he sees, audience are going to see that. Okay. that's my definition.
One more thing to add, right? So usually, like, when you take this, we like, you know, as a, like a crew, like, you know, we used to take breaks, but this guy used to be there like all the time holding to it. He used to have that back, you know, I mean, thing to support him. And like, you know, that house shoot where we have a lot of steps going back and forth, back and forth.
True,
he never used to give camera to anybody else. He used to
carry that. That is the heaviest thing in the shoot spot, I know. Okay.
Yeah, even I was part of one scene. It's a chasing scene.
Okay.
So, but I was discussing it. It actually takes you to the another scene where I made that miniature, which will cause there.
Yeah,
so,
it was asking.
But I was remembered that the effects what they tried in this movie. I was talking to Pawan before that, but they want to try like a glass breaking, all these things.
Yes.
I never done that, and I never seen who is doing that one, right?
Yes.
We always seen all these kind of effects in the feature films.
Right.
But here, how are they going to try? And so he shared me the location. Okay,
wow.
You come there.
Okay.
So I went there.
Okay.
That, as he said, all the locations are taken care of for Pawan, right?
Yeah.
I never seen that location in US. Okay, these kind of locations are also there.
Right. Right.
And there it's kind of cheesy.
Is that
so
some of the shots in LA? Or?
No. Everything is in
is
area.
Here.
Everything,
oh wow!
Completely,
it's amazing, man.
Yeah.
It's really nice, and I bet actually you are going to be the most wanted cameraman here in Bay Area.
Right.
It's amazing, and because you have all kind of elements in this film, like car chasing, fighting, and especially in the fight scene, the way you have handled the angles, it is actually bringing everybody's location where they are, and you know, like we were easily visualize actually who is coming from where, and you know, it's not like kind of, oh, they're jumping from nowhere and I don't know where it's going, why, what's this going on? No, it's not like that. It's completely brought the entire picture, and it's an excellent work you have done.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, and I think people are going to enjoy your camera work, I guess.
Thank you.
So,
yeah, I mean, Srikanth and Pawan, they are very good at designing shots.
Okay.
Any action sequence. Uh-huh. I think he also acted as a one of.
Let's not go there now.
Okay.
Let's not go there now. They each were each and everything.
He was there.
Yeah. Actors were also amazing.
Yes,
sir.
Yes.
True.
Whenever I see the frame,
right,
the actors were amazing. The main character, hero.
Right.
And the heroine of Gana Bhatt.
I'm a big fan of Gana, by the way.
Yeah.
She's an excellent actress.
Yeah. So Gana, sir, like, I think like we were shooting one of these, fight sequence, like, in South San Francisco,
yeah,
which is like I think she has to drive close to 2 hours to get there.
Okay.
It's like it's at like 11 p.m.
Okay.
And she came with her friend just for like, she was there only for a second.
Oh,
she'll be there just only for a second.
Yeah.
You will see that in the movie.
Yeah,
but you know, I mean, her dedication, like
dedication,
in everything,
yeah,
like, you know, I mean,
is very true.
And one happy thing for me with Nataraj is I worked with a lot of cinematographers before.
Right.
One thing I don't wanted to do with cinematographers, I wish the ideal situation was, I don't want to look at the camera.
Right.
I want to look at the actors and concentrate on getting the performance from them.
Right.
But unfortunately, at our level, we only get cinematographers sometimes who are learning or like who are in the mid-professional level.
Yes.
But with me, on the first B scene that we took, right?
Yeah, right.
I only saw first two shots, two or three shots.
Mm-hmm.
I went behind the camera and how he's shooting.
Yeah.
After that, I didn't even see the camera.
Okay.
Like, a lot of crew used to say, did you see the camera?
Right.
Or like, did you check it? No, I mean, I don't want to interfere or put nose into his, but I'm confident that he will get.
Right.
And when he says that it's not good, it's not good.
Like, it's not good.
We have a visual exchange.
So exactly. Once the scene is done, we used to look at Nataraj.
Okay.
Yeah, then okay, we are safe.
And if he says amazing,
yeah,
like, amazing.
Beautiful.
Very
nice.
So in that way, I think that is an ideal way that all the directors want to concentrate. I mean, I see a lot of budding directors or like many directors, they're glued behind the camera.
Yes. Right.
And like they're more worried about the technicality of bringing film, but like they miss concentrating on the actors checking if the movement is live there.
That's very true. Thank you for this excellent project. Yeah. Hope you should be like very busy in coming days.
He's already.
So
okay.
Even for today,
okay,
I took appointment 3 weeks.
Okay.
3 weeks before.
No. Yeah, and I mean, another thing is, Bharat, I have to come to you. Like I said, your contribution to filmmakers in Bay Area is amazing. My heartfelt thanks for you.
Thank you.
So, I know like, in this film, I noticed so many things that pointed out to you without saying, especially during the exchange of gunshots and fight scenes in the garage and the car chasing, all those things, you know, how challenging it was and how did you manage?
So this is the first film I had to do some car chases. So I was actually inspired by what is on the picture. So my first thing when we were doing a spotting session with Pawan was like, okay, how am I going to make justice to this one? Because I've never done it. I told Pawan, I've never done, this is way complicated.
Yeah.
This is way deeper than I thought I was going to do.
Right.
So, and Pawan was like, nope, take your time.
Yeah.
We want this to be believable. So, so my primary objective was like, okay, so three aspects, right? So one is what you see, can we make it believable with sound?
Yes.
And then second was like the things that you don't see, like the tripping thing and few other things that we actually discussed.
Right.
And then find a right balance between that and the music and everything else that's going on visually.
Right.
So we kind of go on back and forth, and I After like first couple of meetings, I totally understood where what Pawan is looking for. Right. And then I usually give him options like, here is one and here is one. Okay. Which one do you like, which one you don't like.
Okay.
Also, the other thing is like a lot of freedom. So yes. Pawan is like, okay, you own this scene. This is what I am expecting at the end of. This is the feeling I'm expecting.
Right, go for it.
And then I usually go crazy or I tone it down completely and then let him make the call.
Right.
You know, like it's really amazing when you're seeing each and every department. Like the end product, the film that we are watching on the screen is something happening, right? Some happenings actually. So like your job is like when something is happening based on the situation, what kind of noises that we hear which we don't notice at all.
We should not distract the from visuals, but at the same time given enough subtle hints across the board to kind of build up the tension or convey the story
and make it real,
make it real.
Exactly. Yeah, it's amazing. And now people started noticing all those things, you know, those days. I think when I was like you guys, I don't think what is sound design, what is music, what is like all those things. Now people are now technically they know what it is, and you have done an excellent job, Bharat. And how did you find him, you know? He's a very busy guy, not easy.
I think I should say at my level, like, you know, with the experience I have in filmmaking, I'm blessed to work with actually Bharat.
Okay.
Because the way, the amount of time he puts in
is
unimaginable. Like, I mean, you cannot imagine how much, I mean, I think we were working on sound just for 1 year.
Right, wow.
We finished the shoot in like 2 to 3 months.
Yeah.
The sound itself just took 8 to 9 months. We are still not done. We are still trying different mixing.
Improvising.
Yeah.
And
so we did a lot of on-set sound recording.
Okay.
Because I'm fan of on-set sound design.
Right.
I mean, like unlike many of the South Indian movies, we do a lot of dubbing actually.
Okay.
Everything is done in dubbing, and it's not realistic. We are used to a kind of sound design where the dialogue plays a major role.
Right.
Everything is clean.
Right.
Music and dialogue plays a major role, and the sound design has less importance. But that is changing now. Like, I mean, there are a lot of inspiring movies where new filmmakers are putting more focus on sound, and they are actually, even though it's not crystal clear, they are grabbing the sound on set.
Right.
And I'm a big fan of on-set sound.
Okay.
And as much as we can, we actually took on-set sound. We used the on-set sound, but there are lots of lots of sound designs we had to put. So we tried all different ways.
Right. Like
we used on-set sound. We used the libraries.
Right.
We did some Foley sound mimic that. So we there are like countless number of actors who did like dubbings, human sounds for this.
Yeah.
And I think for him, like it's I keep sending him, okay, these are the new sounds I recorded.
That's great, great work. Now, just now I talked about the locations, and even though we have wonderful places in and around for our story, an art director is also a very important person.
Mm-hmm.
I have a lot of questions, but that should not reveal the technique, you know, for the film. It should not be a spoiler.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm just asking, what is a challenging work for you in this film?
So challenging thing, when I talked to Pawan, right, he said there is a there is some chase scene.
Yeah.
Okay. On that scene, he wants something which is very hard to shoot it.
Okay.
So so what is the alternative for that?
Okay.
So he want I want
build
this.
Build a structure.
Basically.
Yeah.
So basically, we need to build a structure.
Build a life. Actually, we need to demolish a structure.
Okay.
So this much big thing, I want to shoot it here. He said.
Okay. Okay.
So why you are saying like this? Then he said like there is a concept called miniature.
Oh.
Oh. Okay. Then go there, search for it. Okay. This is what you are asking for. Okay. Let's do it.
But you learned.
Yeah. Learned and so.
Wow. Okay.
So then it's okay, we can do this, but we have to match it with the real scene, right?
Exactly.
So that is the challenging task.
Challenging.
We don't know which, from where they shot.
Okay.
So the same color we have to put it here.
Yes.
The same, if there are any logos, if there are any obstacles, or if there are any properties around that scene,
that is,
right? Okay. Everything has to be recreated here.
In a miniature.
In a miniature.
Okay.
So I don't know how it came, but because I didn't see that.
So we'll do one thing. After we'll have a questionnaire after the movie, and let us ask the audience, guys, ready? Okay, we are going to ask you a question. Find out which is the miniature. All right?
Yeah.
And we'll see. Okay.
So, I have seen it like hundreds of times.
Okay.
And I don't know which one is miniature.
Okay. I'm here. Just before this interview, right? I was talking to him about that particular scene, and he said it's a miniature. Oh my God! Really? Oh, okay. So let us see how many people are going to find it. Nice and. Yeah, so how you are planning to release this film?
So we are releasing this movie in theaters. Mm-hmm. We are actually just releasing for only two shows for now.
Uh-huh. Okay.
We want to see how audience like it, and if more people are interested, we are thinking to screen more screens. But as of now, we are just doing like a two screens release.
Sure. Yeah, we'll do, and good luck
with you
and with your entire team. And it's hard work, I know. Yeah. And you guys have to like thank your family members for letting you guys do this.
That's right.
Yeah. So
that's the first thing.
That's the first thing.
I think we need to, maybe I'll put this first in the editing.
Yes.
And like
dedicate to the families. You know, you know, like,
because there is one point of time where we have the whole story happens. The reason it's purple night is the whole story happens in the night time. From one point of the movie.
Okay.
Entire second half.
Okay.
So. We have to only start shooting in night, like, we have to wait until it gets dark, and like we used to come at like morning, we used to shoot all the night in the morning.
And all the families helped us too, right? Like Ratnesh's family and
good luck for everyone, for your all your future projects.
Thank you.
And I'm so glad to take a look and interview you guys and get to know you and introduce you to the audience. And good luck.
Thank you.
Guys, please watch. Don't watch it on YouTube. Go to the theater and watch it, okay? And encourage these talents, because just making a film, when you look at the screen, it looks very easy. And and you can easily pass on it. But it's very difficult. Like Pavan says, this project, he is working for 2 years, right? So a lot of people's behind the screen, they have put their efforts. And their talents, showcase their talents. So finally, you guys have to like encourage and motivate them to make more movies like that. And good luck.